This C# program is used to iterate the elements of an array using for each loop. You have to iterate the elements of an integer array using a for each loop, and we need to find the sum of even and odd numbers in the array. First, we are declaring an array with the name num, which is of integer array, and the array is initialized with set of values from 1 to 10. So during the declaration of array, we mentioned the first data type followed by the brackets that is used to indicate that it's an array, and array name, which is num, followed by equal to symbol and the initialized values. Two variables are declared, s odd and s even, which is initialized as 0 to store the sum of odd and sum of even numbers. Then we have started with a for each loop. In for each loop, first we have to mention the data type of each element. So since we are having an integer array, the data type of each element of the array will be integer, followed by the variable where the element need to be stored during each iteration, and in keyword and the array name. Each element from the enum array will be taken during the iteration and it will get stored into the variable n. So from the array enum, it will take first value 1 and store into n during first iteration. During second iteration, value 2 will get stored into the variable n. Now inside the loop, we check whether n is divisible by 2. If it is divisible by 2, we add the value n into the sum of even. Else we add the value with the sum of odd, so that s even will get added with the sum of even numbers and s odd will get added with the sum of odd numbers from the array. After the for loop, by using console.writeline, we display the values of sum of even numbers and sum of odd numbers. By using $, we are formatting the output by including the variables value and string. So it will display the value of sum of s even variable and s odd variable inside the string during the output. Execute and see the program output. Similarly, by using for each loop, access the element of an integer array and find the sum of all the elements and display its average, and kindly comment below.